We're after yet another Leinster final where Dublin are the champions, worthy champions. There was no doubt about it. Meath really were played out of it. I'm joined by former Meath footballer Anthony Moyles. You found that a hard watch, but even worse than a hard watch, you were bored.
Yeah, bored. I'd say like the other 40-odd thousand, if that can be believed. Here, yeah, you know, first half, Meath had a plan, executed relatively well. Had, I think, three off the post and about five or six wides, which were relatively easy wides, I would suggest. A good number of place balls. You always got the sense that Dublin were kind of in only around third gear, and if they really wanted up it, they could have. Jack McCaffrey kind of skint and kind of put the afterburners on for a couple of scores, and they showed glimpses. But they were a bit sloppy, Dublin. You know, Meath were probably deploying a similar tactic that they have done in a number of games where they kind of give you the ball and they try and put you into certain areas of the field. So it was working quite well. And as I was saying to you at half-time, I really hoped they'd come out for that first 10 minutes of the second half and try to change it, you know, go for it a little bit more, put more fellas up front, and instead of probably being a bit more reticent actually about it, actually have a bit more of a go. But as the wides tally started to ratchet up, what invariably happens is fellas get shot shy, they start giving the ball, passing the buck, passing the responsibility, guys don't take players on, and then someone takes a rash shot and either goes way wide or it gets blocked down, which we saw, and then Dublin counter-attacked. As soon as the goal went in, that's it, good luck.
That's a really kind of interesting way to put it. That's it, good luck. That's what everybody expected with Dublin. And Meads, you know, if they had gotten a few of those scores, it might have been different. Dublin still would have won, but they might have given them a game. When I was downstairs, I was speaking to Colm Nally, one of the Mead selectors, and he was trying to be as positive as he could. He said, we came with a game plan, you know, yes, the scoring wasn't there, but a lot of things up to the scoring was there, and we, to get to this level, we need to play more high-quality games, and Division 1 will help us. With that display, though, that ain't going to cut it in Division 1 with any team.
No, it's not. And you know, I think where they were doing really, really well was, you just mentioned it there, they were one-on-one at the defence, you know, and I felt a little bit disappointed. I felt sorry for the defenders, to be honest with you. They put in a serious shift. They were marking arguably some of the best forwards in the country, and we're doing well. We're holding their own. We're getting physical with them. We're getting out in front, getting hands in. The slippy ball helped. But when you get the ball up the field, then it's all about that extra pass. It's all about giving the player the best opportunity, and it's all about just kind of slipping them in. You saw the scores then with Dublin were getting. They were easy scores. You know, guys were, you know, kind of blocking a man, just popping a pass out and just letting you slip it over with your left or right foot. Whereas the Meath scores were kind of, I'm on the run, I'm on my own, or the wides really, and it was a bit of a shot from 40, 45 metres. There was nothing really, I'd be really interested in see, you know, where were the wides. There was very, very little from within the D. It was all kind of outside. And it wasn't like Dublin were crowding it. It was just that the shot selection was poor, really. And instead, as I say, of taking that extra pass, you know, kind of finding a man, trying to just control it a little bit more, it was a bit rash when it got up there. And that's very, very disheartening for a defender. You can imagine, you know, you're after defending Mannion, you've got a hand in, you're really, really tired, you've got the ball up the field, you've maybe chased it up, you're hoping that the lads can kick the ball over the bar, that we face a kick out, and next thing the ball's just coming right back at you. Like, I'd say Cluxton hardly kicked out the ball today. Like, I mean, okay, the tally wide was 12, but the amount of times Meath forwards were blocked down, the amount of times they just ran down blind alleys in the second half. Disappointing. I can see where Colm is saying, yes, there are positives, but from two to kind of probably eight or nine, there was positives, you know, from a defensive point of view. But they need to probably just say to themselves, listen, guys, if we're winning and we're doing so well in the defence and we're getting the ball up the field, we have to take the extra pass. We have to bring men into it a bit more.
Will, obviously, this game will teach them lessons. And I don't want to take away from the Dublin brilliance, because they're a wonderful team and they're amazing to watch, and you have to appreciate their brilliance. But all that aside, when Meath go home and they'll be looking over these videos and stuff, they'll see the positives, they'll see the not so positives. Do they have any time to take any positive learnings from it very, very quickly into the next game?
It's going to be hard. I think that what they can do is they can say, right, we got a lot of things correct, so let's just double down on that. We maintain that again. Was it a specific game plan just for Dublin? No, I don't think so. They've been doing that kind of game where they've been kind of allowing the opposition to have the ball to a certain degree and then look to trap them and take the ball off them. So I think they'll continue to do that. I think just the next time they have to just be, they have to mind the ball a little bit better. The Dublin point of view is, look, you know, I was referencing it to Joe there when we were talking live on air. You know, I think there was about 11 Dublin players actually did the parade around the stadium with the cup. you know, not even the whole panel did it. Like, they're just, I think they're bored with it. You know, they're just bored winning them. They see that it's probably All-Ireland final day. I'd say even the Super 8s are kind of like, you know, are they kind of nearly still in fine-tuning mode? They probably are. And that's a desperate thing to say for a Leinster final, and from a Meath perspective, and even from all the other counties in Leinster. It's desperate to see that. But it's not Dublin's fault. Although you could argue, let's not even go there, about funding and everything else. But it's not the players who are out in the pitch's fault. Mannion was very, very good today. I thought Jack McCaffrey was excellent. McCarthy is a big loss for them. I think he suffered a fairly bad knee injury. So he's a massive loss for them down the line. But, you know, I thought what Meath were crying out for today, and they did it at the start. You know, myself and yourself were talking about it, where they put a high ball, crossfield ball in, and it caused a bit of pandemonium in the first few minutes with Philly McMahon in there. And then they stopped doing it. You know, they brought Mickey Newman out and they left Conlon inside. Now, if I'm Donegal, I'm thinking you can switch Murphy in and out of there, put him in on the square, send some high balls in, have McBurtie beside him and Brennan inside him. And what actually that causes is it causes your half back line to actually step backwards, closer to your full back line, which essentially moves your whole defence back down the pitch. So when you're coming up with the ball, you won't hit that line of defenders way up the pitch. You'll actually hit it a little bit further back, so it gives you more space. I think that's one way that you can get at Dublin, and I think it's one way, and possibly a way that certainly Donegal are equipped to do it with the likes of Murphy, but unfortunately for me today they weren't.
On a different subject entirely, many's a time Tommy Welch comes and brings me food. Today yeah. You brought me a muffin and you brought me crisps and lots of other little goodies, wine gums as well. I went downstairs to get interviews, I came back, he'd eaten what was left of my muffin, and now he's after squashing up his elbow.
Yeah, well, you know, it's cold here. Honestly, I was up here on my own, the rain was lashing down, there's seagulls flying around, I'm looking out and I'm just going, this is probably one of the most depressing moments of my life. So the muffin was all I had to give me a little bit of a zest.
We'll leave the muffin man for me, this muffin. Thank you very much for your time, Gravila Margaret.